Christian life is not merely a life that we live for ourselves, trying to cope up with our situations and problems and move on in life. No. Christianity is a time to be aware of the Lord, the Holy Spirit in us. To be aware of the Holy Spirit. Learn to have fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Learn to possess all that the Holy Spirit gives to us, the gifts and fruits. If you have not learned, still you are running. Sorry, it's your mistake. What I have given to you, you are not willing to possess. You don't understand the depth of your own Christian life. Jesus says, the fourth witness is, I have given you my own spirit. And he is also in today's readings are so depth. He says three reasons, he says, why you do not know the Holy Spirit. Number one, he says, you have never heard his voice. You have never heard. You don't have time. You don't have time. Once I remember in the novitiate, my novice master was telling me something, because as I was discussing with my friend, the novice master said, I didn't hear. I went behind the whole novice master and said, novice master, sir, father, you said something. Then he told me, I told you not to talk. He is telling, I didn't hear him properly. So not only I was talking to my friend, now I am disturbing the silence of even the novice master. Because I have not heard him properly. The Lord says, you have never heard the Holy Spirit. Who are you? He will teach you. What are the things he has kept for you? When he loves you, why does he allow these things in your life? Nobody is created for death. I have not chosen you for death. If I allow certain problems in your life, there is something behind that problem, a mission behind. Only a man with the light is sent to the darkness. I have sent you with my spirit to the dark, your problems, your situations that are broken, wounded, and so on. And only with the light you can see what is in darkness. And only in the presence of my spirit, you can understand who are you, what's happening to you. So these 21 days, focus your life to hunger for the Holy Spirit and how to possess the Holy Spirit. Cry to him. He says, number one, you have never heard his voice. Number two, you have never seen how he shapes your life. How does he work in your life? The Holy Spirit is working with us. Jesus says, Holy Spirit, I have sent you as a witness. You are not able to have him because you have not heard his voice. And number two, you do not know how he shapes your life. Number three, his word has never found home in you. The Holy Spirit comes the more you cling to the word of God. Jesus said in John 14:19, the words that I speak to you will give you my life and my spirit. You have not found Holy Spirit in your heart because his word has not found home in you. You have no time for the word of God. Your time for the books, your time for the TV. If you don't watch the newspaper, you feel upset that you have not read the newspaper. Have you felt upset that you have not read my word? You have not spoken to me. When I was coming from Pune as a new young priest, a Jesuit priest who led me into scripture, he told me, Christu, remember this one sentence. I know you love to preach the word of God, but keep this advice with you. Don't dare to speak about God if you have not spoken to God. Don't dare to speak about God if you have not spoken to God. That's what Jesus is telling us today. You have not witnessed my spirit because you have never heard his voice. You don't understand how he is shaping your life. Number three, you have not found the word of God in your heart. Only when you have the word of God, my spirit will operate. You know, Genesis chapter 1, Holy Spirit was hovering over the water. It was shapeless, darkness. But the Holy Spirit was waiting for the word of God to come. And when the word of God came, let there be light, immediately the Holy Spirit used that word and made the things according to the word. So when you find home for the word of God in your heart, you will experience my spirit. Fifth, he says, you don't believe in me, that the Father has sent me for you. And he gives another great secret which all of us are doing. He says, you think the word of God itself gives eternal life? If the scriptures, do you know, they testify me. By just merely reading the word of God or saying, do you think that things will happen? The word of God should lead you to me. The word of God should lead you to encounter me, hear me. The word of God should help you to understand my heart. So the word of God is only a testimony for you. Yet you refuse to come to me and to receive my life. He says, you are doing 5 things, he says. Number 1, you refuse to come to me to receive life. Number 2, he says, your glory is nothing to me. Do you think that by you are coming to me, I am going to get something? I have enough and more angels to glorify me. So understand, your glory is nothing to me. But 3, I know you well, he says. I know yet to set of yours. Still I am after you. I am loving you. Open your heart and understand, why do I love you? 4, he says, you have no love of God in you. You are busy with 101 things. You have lost your love for God. That's what he said in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 3 to 4. He says, these people, they have more love to fulfill their pleasures than to give pleasure to the Lord. Same thing Jesus is saying, you have no love for God in you. I have come in the name of my Father, and you have not accepted me. Close your eyes for a minute. The Lord is telling you, the Lord is telling each one of us, my son, my daughter, understand my heart. I am coming to you. You don't accept my witness. But if someone comes, immediately you throw yourself. Some message comes in your internet, in your cell phone, in WhatsApp, and you accept it. And you send to so many people and you discuss about it. You are taking the witness of people, and you are not coming to me. You are not accepting my testimony. But at the same time, you easily open yourself to the testimony of so many people, so many things in the world. How is this? You could spend more time to watch a movie, but you have not time to talk to me. You have time to argue with your people. You have no time to carry the burden of each other to me. You look at each other for glory and not concerned about the glory that comes from God. Jesus says, you look at each other for glory. You look at each other, will this man support me? Will this girl, if I help, will she help me? If I give this, what will I get out of it? You are looking at each other for glory, the worldly glory, the passing glory. Why are you, when are you going to be concerned about the heavenly glory which I want to give it to you? Seventh, he says, you have trusted in Moses. You have trusted about so many people. And tell you, the days are coming, Moses himself will stand before me and accuse you. The days of judgments are nearby. Don't be a fool, but be a witness to God. Place your hands over your heart. Jesus says seven things. Take into your heart. Number one, you refuse to come to me. Why? And receive my life. Don't you know I am the life for you? I am the way for you. Why are you not burning in your heart? Why are you not having that desire, hunger for me? Ask yourself. Number two, remember your glory. By coming to me, you are not going to do anything for me. Number three, remember I know you well, so I can guide you. Only I know you well. It's better to surrender your life to the one who knows you well, who loves you well, who died for you and gave his life for you. What's stopping you? Fourth, he says, you have no love of God in you. He said in the book of Genesis, in the book of Revelation chapter 2, what happened to your first love? Once upon a time, you are longing for God. You did so many things. Now what happened to that love? Fifth, he says, I have come in the name of my Father and you have not accepted me. But if somebody comes in their names and you have time for them, you have time for the world, you have time to please yourself. What is this? Why is it? Sixth, he says, you look at each other. I scratch you, you scratch me. How long? How long? He says, why are you not concerned about the glory which God wants to give it to you? Why is it not your heart hungering, thirsting for my glory, which I want to give it to you? Seventh, he says, the days are coming, the days of judgment. Don't lose yourself. What is the use of winning the whole world? And if you lost your soul, what is the use of it? Lifting up your hands, surrender your life to him. Tell him, here I am, Lord.